सादैकमयीम् अनन्यपरतन्त्रां नवरसरुचिरां निर्मितिम् आदधति भारतीकवेर्जयति. सो वि आर् लुकिङ्ग् एट् दोषास्. वि लुक्ड् एट् सम् आफ् द वाक्यदोषास् अण्टिल् वाचकत्वं वि वर् एबल् टु डू लास्ट् क्लास्. नौ वि हाव् टु स्टार्ट् वित् अश्लीलम्. ओके, लेट् मी टेक् अप् द टेक्स्ट् फस्ट्. सो देर् आर् त्री टैप्स् आफ् अश्लीलम्. One is Vrida Janakam, next is Jugupsa, third one is Amangalam. First one, we saw in the Padagatam, as where he used the word Sadhanam. As usual, only one word, if the dosha exists only in one word, then it is Padagatam. If the dosha exists in many words, then you take it as Vakya, Pada Samuhaha Vakyam. So if the dosha exists in many words, and the idea that gives rise, if it gives rise to a very sort of a vulgar and different type of meaning, then it is ashlila vrida janakam. Bhute bhupate ruts upasarpanti kampana vamalochana tattat praharana utsahavati mohanam adadho. The main meaning of this shloka is bhupatehe kampana. Bhupatehe kampana. Kampana is sena. Bhupatehe nripasya sena. Upasarpanti vamalochana sati upasarpanti. Vamalochana means vama has two meanings here. One is viruddha and another is beautiful. So based on that two meanings, we are going to come up with an this gives us an image of an ashlila. A very vulgar or an indecent picture in our mind. Here, Bhutpatehe Kampana, the Sena, is number one, it is Vamalochana. So it has a hateful eye. Vamalochana Viruddha Lochanam Yasyaha. Here, Viruddha Lochanam, we will take it as Shatruna Prati Viruddha Lochanam. So she has a very, the Sena, the army has a very hateful eye towards the enemies. Next is Tattat Praharana Utsahavati. Oh, Upasarpanti. Upasarpanti, it is going near or it is approaching the Shatru. Shatru Shatru Abhimukam Asti. So Upasarpanti, Shatrunam Samipam Gacchati. तत्तत् प्रहरणम् उत्साहवति. तत्तत् प्रहरणं तत्तद् आयुधविशेष उपयोगे उत्साहः अस्ति सेनायाः. सो तत्तत् प्रहरणम् उत्साहवति, इट् इस् वेरि एन्थूसियास्टिक्. दि एण्टैर् आर्मी इस् एन्थूसियास्टिक् अबौट् यूसिङ्ग् डिफ्रेण्ट् टैप्स् आफ़् अटाक्स् आर् डिफ्रेण्ट् डिफ्रेण्ट् आयुध. मोहनम् आदधौ. मोहनम् आददौ, इट् क्रियेट्स् एन् अन्कान्शियस् आर् इट् डेस्ट्राय्स् दि एनिमीस् आर् इट् रेण्डर्स् देम् अन्कान्शियस्. It completely makes the enemy unconscious. That is one thing. Now, this is the main idea that a poet wishes to convey, or he is trying to describe the king's army in such a manner. The meaning that comes out of words like upasarpana, praharana, mohana, and vamalochana, these words, vamalochana is okay. Vamalochana is not bad, but Kampana, Praharana, and Upasarpana, and Mohana, these are words that give a very obscene meaning. In the sense, Upasarpanti, it is talking of a woman, Vamalochana, a beautiful-eyed lady who wishes to approach, how it describes her. And the description given here is not very conducive or very beautiful description. When you say Upasarpanti, she is approaching the Nayaka with lust. So she is directly expressing her opinion to have a union with the Nayaka. That is Upasarpanam. Upasarpanam, Ratarthe Upasarpanam is Upasarpanti Vamalochana. She wishes to be with him. Next is Kampana. She is also shaking. Or Kampana means not Kampa Yukta, but Anyana Kampayukta Karoti. She makes others shake with excessive lust. So the moment people see her, they want to be with her. That is Kampana. तत्तत् प्रहरण उत्साहवति शी बिकम्स् शी इस् ईगर् टु यूस् मेथड्स् दट् आर् मेन्शन्ड् इन् द कामशास्त्र लैक् प्रहरण एक्सेट्रा हीटिङ्ग् एन् आल् देट् ड्यूरिङ्ग् द union. These are the things that she wants to do, or utsaha, her enthusiasm is there in using these methods. So the way he expresses it is very explicit in what she wants to do. And while describing an army, this is not something which should be done. And Mohanam Adadav, she makes people completely unconscious or unaware of their surroundings because of the lust that she induces in people. So Mohanam Adadav, she makes them unconscious. If in a big sabha, a kavi is praising the army of a king, then it is a dosha. It is a vakyagatam ashleelam vridadayitvam, vridadayitvat ashleelam. Whereas, where can this be a guna? He highlights another place later, after all the padamsha dosha and all are done, he will talk about how dosha namapi gunatva pakshe katham sthapaniyam. So there he will say how this can become a guna if in an antapura there are some 20 ladies who are talking with each other and they are regaling stories about the night before, then this becomes a guna. Where you are exchanging stories of love, you're exchanging stories of what it has been. So there the double meaning works. It is necessary there because the situation is different. So you always have to think about the context, and it is only the context that makes it a guna or a dosha. The auchityam of that, prakarana auchityam, is important. अत्र उपसर्पण प्रहरण मोहन शब्दाः दीस् वर्ड्स् व्रीडादायित्वात् दे गिव् रैस् टु यु फील् अशेम् टु हियर् दीस् वर्ड्स् बिकास् आफ् द डबल् मीनिङ्ग् दट् एक्सिस्ट् एण्ड् हेन्स् इट् इस् अश्लीलत्वम् द नेक्स्ट् वन् इस् जुगुप्सा इट् इस् एक्स्ट्रीम्लि नासियेटिङ्ग् श्लोक ते अन्यैः वान्तं समश्नन्ति पर उत्सर्गं च भुञ्जते इतर अर्थग्रहे येषां कवीनां स्यात् प्रवर्तनम् इवन् द पदगतं वास् बेटर् ऐ थिङ्क् द पदगतं वास् वायुं ददति नायिका इस् शीस् गाट् नायिका इस् ट्रैङ्ग् टु कन्सोल् द नायिका ही इस् डन् अन् अपराध एण्ड् ही बिहेव्स् शी हिट्स् हिम् वित् द लीला कमलम् and he behaves as if that pollen grain has gone into his eye, and she blows into his eye to relieve his eye of that redness or that allergy. And there they use the word vayum dadati, and in that gives rise to the idea of a passing gas or something. So that gives us the idea of apana vayu. Here it is vakyagatam, so the entire meaning should be jugupsayuktam. How is this? He's talking about yesham kavinam itara arthagrahe pravartanam tesham kavinam atra so yesham kavinam those poets itara arthagrahe. This is a topic which is dealt with in Dvanyaloka in the fourth udyota in a very beautiful manner. Samvada, he talks about samvada in three different ways, where he says plagiarism is something which we think it is a very new topic. It is not. So plagiarism has been spoken about in the 9th century by Anandavardhana. He talks about it as samvada, where one poet takes an idea from another poet. He can either use the same words and write. It is like an upama, or it is just the same reflection. That is the adhama. If you use the idea and you write it in your own manner, then that is the madhyama. If you take the idea and use your own creativity and pratibha in it and write, then that is the uttama. Mostly you will find the uttama type of samvada between Kalidasa and Naishadhakara. Naishadhakara has described Nala and Damayanti in such a beautiful manner. He will use the word yuva dhairya lopinam. So when he says talks about Damayanti's guna, asyaha gunotkaram swakanti kirti vrajamoktikasrajaha shrayantam antarghatana gunashriyam. Kadachit nalo api gunotkaram ashrunot lokat. That's, I don't remember the whole shloka. He says, Yuva dhairya lopinam for her guna. Damayanti's guna is such that her soundaryam is such that it is Yuva dhairya lopinam. The word that he uses is a complete takeoff from Kalidasa's Kumarasambhava, where he uses Haras tukinchit pravilapta dhairya. Hara Shiva, the moment Manmatha keeps that bana on his bow, Shiva just experiences a little shake in his courage. Kinchit pravilupta dhairya. The words he uses are very different. And so, Uma muke bimba phaladaroshte vyaparayamasa vilochane. All three eyes of his fell on the lips of Uma. Uma muke, not he first says it falls on Uma's mukha. No, he further, confines it to bimba phaladaroshte on her lips with an intention, That is where his idea reveals for the first time in Kumarasambhava. The reason for that, Haras tukinchit pravilupta dhairya. His dhairya was a little bit shaken. So he takes that idea, the same idea, and Naishadhakara turns it into a different manner. See, Nala also heard about Damayanti's guna for the first time. He did not see her. So he takes that idea and uses it as Yuva dhairya lopinam gunotkaram. In that Yuva, she destroys the dhairya of all the youth. And in all that youth, if you take that as the superset, Nala is included in that. So which means he is indicating that his dhairya is also going to be destroyed at that point. And by hearing the gunas of Damayanti. That is how you take an idea of another kavi and do it. So here he talks about how one kavi, if they just take the same thing, we say this, you eat and vomit, right? You read for the exam and then you just regurgitate it everything during the exam and then finish it off, you forget everything. That's all you do. He uses the same idea that we normally colloquially talk about among friends, and he uses that in this shloka, which is actually jugupsayuktam. In a sabha, in a poetry, if you want to, and the way he writes it is also very nauseating in the sense, yesham kavinam pravartanam, the marga of some of kavis, which is either arthagrahe pravartanam syat, those kavis who use others' meaning, arthagrahe pravartanam, they follow the path and use only the meaning of other people's words. They, what do they do? They anyehi vantam samashnanti. They actually eat the vomit. Vantam is that which has come out of someone's mouth, and that is atat ashnanti. And para utsargam cha bhunjate. Utsargam is excreta. So it's a very, very nauseating way to put the whole thing in. Nobody would want to copy them, right? That's why you should read Dvanyaloka, where he says in the Samvada, he talks about how it is Adhama, Madhyama, and Uttama. Even the way he says the Adhama itself is not, it is like a Bimba Pratibimba Bhava. So Bimba Pratibimbam is the lowest method. It does not use such Ashlila words to convey the meaning of how bad the Adhama Samvada is, Adhama way of copying from others. So he just says Bimba Pratibimba Bhava. The another is Chitra Iva. So the Madhyama plagiarism. So yeah, the Adhama plagiarism is Bimba Pratibimbam, where you look at a mirror, it is yourself, but there is no life in it. But if it is a portrait, you add some life to it, you add your own beauty to it. That is your portrait. That is the Madhyama. I forgot what he does for the Uttama, the comparison he says for the Uttama. Long time back. ओके सो तयते अन्यैर् वान्तं समश्नन्ति परोत्सर्गं च भुञ्जते इतर अर्थग्रहे येषां कवीनां स्यात् प्रवर्तनं अत्र वान्त उत्सर्गप्रवर्तन शब्दाः जुगुप्सादायिनः प्रवर्तनम् इस् प्रवर्तनम् अण्ड् उत्सर्गं बोत् मीन् द सेम् थिङ्ग् ओके नेक्स्ट् वन् इस् अमङ्गल पितृवसतिम् अहं व्रजामि तां सह परिवारजनेन यत्र मे भवति सपदि पावकान्वये हृदयम् अशेषितशोकशल्यकम् A wife who is very upset with her husband wants to go away to her father's house. So she's saying, Aham pitruvasatim vrajami. I will go immediately now. With whom? Parivara janena saha aham tam pitruvasatim gamishyami vrajami. I'm going to go to my father's house. Parivara janena along with my servants. Yatra where pitruvasatyam. Where me hridayam shoka shalyakam asheshita shoka shalyakam shoka is a shalya shalya is something which is constantly embedded inside that sort of a wedge my grief is like a wedge which cannot be removed but if I go to my father's house that grief will be completely removed asheshita there will be nothing remaining na sheshitam shoka shalyakam so when you remove a wedge sometimes you know you can pull it halfway and a little bit of a portion imagine an arrow which is stuck you are trying to remove it you cannot remove it you just break it and a little portion is there inside that is sheshitam that is remaining asheshitam means that completely it is removed that wedge or that foreign object is removed so ashe from the hridayam so hridayam my mind becomes something which has been the where from where the shoka has been completely removed यस्मात् शोकशल्यं सम्पूर्णतया अपसारितम् सो तादृशं हृदयं भवति वेर् यत्र पावक अन्वये पावक पुण्य पुण्य अन्वये यस्मिन् कुले मम हृदयं शोकरहितं भवेत् तादृशीं पितृवसतिम् अहं व्रजामि इट्स् द मेन् मीनिङ्ग् हियर् It's what the pati, patni wishes to convey to her pati. She says, let me go to my father's house along with my servants. Where in that pure anvaya, pure kulam, pavaka anvaye, mama hridayam, my mind will be completely asheshita shoka shalyakam. Okay. Sapadi. Sapadi means immediately. Immediately my heart will... be rid of the grief. Now the words pitru griham, instead of pitru griham, she is using the word pitru vasati or even pitru griham is also fine. Pitru vasati is also the same meaning only. Pitru, the word pitru itself gives rise to the meaning of ancestors, not only father. So janakaha is different from pitru. Pitru is a common word that you can use for all ancestors. So immediately the idea of pitru vasati means smashanam comes to the mind. And I am going to go to not only smashanam because there is the word of pavaka and asheshita shoka. These are words that give rise to a smashana where there is a fire and in that fire I will completely my hridayam will be completely destroyed in the sense it will become a bhasmam so the idea of the amangalatvam comes about here it is inauspicious to talk about smashanam even in a normal conversation we try to avoid things like you know at one point if I die you know what you should do you know how you should live we never talk about possibilities of that manner because it is inauspicious to talk about those things in a very this way we will say you know there are so many devatas around you and they will keep saying tathastu so always you have to speak and think good things and when you speak out also you have to speak good things because at every sentence of yours, there will be some devata beside you saying tathastu, which means. So if you say something bad or inauspicious, and if that devata says tathastu, then it is going to happen. It is the belief that people say. As you train your mind and your speech to say good things, you will start thinking and being leading a good life. That is the idea. Immediately, you don't need to think that you're constantly surrounded by devatas here. It's a good thing also. So that's why you should never talk of amangala arthadayaka words. So pitru vasatim maham rajami tam saha. So here that tam is actually an adjective to the pitru vasati. So pitru vasatim maham rajami tam saha parijanena parivarajanena yatra me bhavati sapadi pavaka anvaye hrudayam asheshita shoka shalyam. Atra pitrugriham ityadau vivakshite. When he wants to, vivakshita, where the poet wishes to say pitru griham, that is janakasya griham, in that the idea that comes to our mind is smashanadi pratitau amangalarthatvam. Smashanadi pratitau sati, because the idea of funeral or smashanam is the funeral grounds, that idea is coming in our mind, it is amangalarthatvam. Okay, now with this Ashlilam is over. I think for that Amangalam, Matpriyaya Vinashate, we looked at Vikramorvashiya verse where he says Matpriyaya Vinashate instead of Virahat. Okay, the next one is Sandigdham. Suralayollasa paraha prapta paryapta kampanaha margana pravano bhaswatu bhutiresha vilokyatam. Sandigdham, we saw it was ashif paramparam vandyam karne kritva kripam kuru was the example we saw for padagatam. Why I'm constantly taking that padagatam and vakyagatam is so that we know that there is two different sections of Padagatam and Vakyagatam, where only one Pada is the problem. In that, Ashif Paramparam, Karne Kritva, and all those words were fine. Only the word Vandyam was a problem. Whether it was Saptami Vibhakti, Vandi, and Vandyam, Vandi Jana, Vandi Jane, Athava, Vandyam, Vandana Yuktam, Pujyam, Ashif Paramparam, Karne Kritva. So whether it was Dvitiya Vibhakti Ekavachanam or Saptami Vibhakti Ekavachanam was the issue there. So this gives rise to a sandeha in our mind as to what the poet wishes to convey. Here, every word is going to give us two meanings, just like Slesha. We cannot take it as Slesha Alankara also because we don't know the context here. If the context is fixed, then there is no issue. The context is fixed, then we may not, it may be a guna. Slesha always comes where both artha are necessary for the meaning, where we take two meanings of the words and say this is like this. The prakritartha aprakritarthena upamiyate slesha alankare. Now here suralayo ullasa paraha, one meaning is for a king, the other meaning is for some random person who is in a liquor shop or he is extremely intoxicated. We are talking about, so the two cannot even be compared here. You cannot compare a king with some random person, nor can you compare a random person who is extremely intoxicated to a king. So both, even if you take it as slesha, there is no purpose to that slesha. Hence the, and so we, the meaning is doubtful as to whom is the poet talking about. So let us look at the two meanings. It's easier if it is in a tabular column for me also to explain, so I just wrote it this way. Suralaya ullasa paraha, so esha vilokyatam. Bhaswat bhutihi eshaha vilokyatam. Let this person be seen. Eshaha vilokyatam. We don't know whether it is eshaha jana vilokyatam, athava eshaha dripaha vilokyatam iti vadati kavihi. So what are the adjectives for him? One is Suralaya Ullasa Paraha. Suraha Devaha. Suralayaha Devanam Alayaha. Griham. So Devata Griham Mandiram. Mandire Ullasaha Yasya. Tadra Mandira Ullase Tatparaha. Saha. So Raktaha Anuraktaha Saha. A king who is very involved in worshipping the Devas, or he is constantly, he is very happy about being in the temple and worshipping the Lord. Every palace will have a private temple, you know, just like how we have a puja graham in our house. The palace will have a private temple itself. That was what, if you look at Tanjavur Brihadeeshwara temple, it was built as an addendum for the palace. So there will be a pathway for the king to come to the temple separately. So it depends on the wealth of the king, whether they can build a big temple or they can have a smaller temple inside their house. So Suralaya Ullasa Tatparaha Prapta Paryapta Kampanaha. Kampana, we saw in that Ashleela verse that Kampana is Sena. So Paryapta Kampanaha Praptaha Prapta Paryapta Kampana Yasya Saha Yam Saha. Sorry, Dutiyadat Purusham. So who has a great army which is paryapta, which has the capability of killing all the shatru. Shatru vada krama sena yasya saha. Margana pravanaha. Marganaha, that which tries to find its target. So marganaha is a bana shara. Lakshyam prati yati margayati. Lakshyam margayati iti marganaha. So it constantly keeps searching for a target. So he is an expert, or Pravanaha is an expert, or he is always involved. Rataha, Anuraktaha, Bhaneshu. He keeps using his bow always. So this is about a king who is fighting in the battlefield, or he is a king who is in the Darbar, who is talking about his Sena, his the bhakti, deva bhakti, sena, and his personal prowess also. Because of all of this, bhasvat bhutihi eshaha, he has a great wealth also with which he looks after the praja. So as a description for the king, it's very beautiful. That's fine. Now what are the ideas that we come about for an intoxicated man? Suralaya Ullasa Paraha. Sura Madira. Surayaha Alayaha Madira Griham. It's a bar. So he gains harsha. He gains happiness by being in the Madira Griham. Prapta Paryapta Kampanaha. His hands are always shaking. Paryapta Kampana. He's, because of that intoxication, he is shaking, shivering. Margana pravanaha, marganam margayati, he keeps searching for things, searching for more and more liquor, or he keeps asking, begging for more. So yachana paraha saha, bhasvat bhutihi, he falls down wherever he wants to, and because of that intoxication, he falls unconscious. So he is dhuli dusaritaha. Bhutihi is vibhuti or dhuli, not vibhuti, but here you have to take it as dust. His body is shining with dust. So yeshaha vilokyatam. Now whom is the poet trying to describe? If the context is fixed, then there is no issue. Now even if the context is fixed, let's say the context is a poet describing a king, this would become anuchitartham. You get it? If the context is fixed, then the dosha would be anuchitartham and not sandegam. Sandigdham. If the context is fixed as the intoxicated person also, then you can probably say, for example, you can, I'm trying to think about how this can be a guna. Maybe a hasya rasam context. Inna Kamakshi, wanted to say something?
இந்த மாதிரி இந்த நாடகத்துல எல்லாம் உபயோகப்படுமா இது?
ஆ
இப்ப
கரெக்ட்.
ஒருத்தருக்கு மறைச்சு சொல்ற மாதிரி சம்திங், ஐ டோன்ட் நோ, மிச்ச கட்டிக்க மாதிரி எனக்கு சொல்ல வரல எக்ஸாக்டா. பட் ஒருத்தருக்கு வந்து ஒரு ஹிடன் மெசேஜ் கொடுக்க பாக்குற மாதிரி சொல்றச்ச, இந்த ஸ்லோகம் எக்ஸாக்டா வராது.
More than a hidden message or anything, if you're looking at a Hasya Rasam, where, you know, instead of a gambling den, there is a description of a Sura Mandiram, Suralayam. Description is there, and he is trying to put in the Hasya Rasa as an Angarasa. And he's probably trying to describe an intoxicated man as a very, you know, Dhairyashali. He is trying to do something very, he thinks he is a king. He wants to bring about that play of words and ridicule an intoxicated man, then this would work. It can in fact be a Hasya Rasa Pradhanam. Huh, why not? Right? Otherwise, because the context is not fixed, keep that in mind always, okay? Because the context is not fixed, this is, the sandeham is there. Suralaya ullasa paraha prapta paryapta kampanaha margana pravanaha bhaswat bhutiresha vilokhyata. What is there? Atra kim suradi shabdaha deva sena deva sena shara vibhutyartaha. So suradi shabdaha, we will take it as sura, kampana, margana and bhuti. शब्दाः देवसेना शर विभूत्यर्थाः अथवा मदिरा कंप याचनम् एंड धूलि धूल्यादि अर्थाः इति संदेहः. दैट इज योर प्रॉब्लम हियर. नेक्स्ट वन इज अप्रतीतम. Apratitam, in the Padagatam we saw it was Dalita Ashayaha, where the word Ashaya was supposed to be Samskara. In Kavya we find that Ashaya is a word that we use for Asha, Manorathaha. So that was the only word that was a problem, the rest was fine. Here the entire shloka is going to be completely about Yoga Shastram only. Tasya Adhimatra, Tasya Adhimatra. अधिमात्र उपायस्य तीव्र संवेगता जुषः दृढ़भूमिः प्रियप्राप्तौ यत्नस्य फलितः सखे. इफ देयर आर एनी मिस्टेक्स इन एनी ऑफ दीस दैट आई से, यू कैन एट्रिब्यूट इट टू अप्रतीत दोष, बिकॉज आई डोंट नो मच अबाउट योग शास्त्रम. आई विल ट्राई टू टेल यू व्हाट इज देयर इन द व्याख्यान. दिस इज टोटली बियॉन्ड माई अंडरस्टैंडिंग एंड नॉलेज. स यत्नः फलितः हे सखे, दैट एफर्ट, द एफर्ट दैट आई हैव टेकन सो फार प्रिय प्राप्तो फॉर अटेनिंग व्हाट आई विश इज फलितः हैज बिकम सक्सेसफुल. दिस इज अ वेरी वेरी सरफेस लेवल ऑफ मीनिंग दैट इज देयर. नाउ हियर प्रिय प्राप्तो मीन प्रिय प्राप्तो, प्रियम इज ऑलवेज आत्मस्वरूपम. There can be nothing else that is more dear to us other than Atma Swarupa. So, Priya Prapto Atma Sakshatkare. Yaha Yatnaha Kritaha Saha Yatnaha Aduna Phalitaha Ityukte Moksha Praptaha. Huh? So, Priya Prapto Yatnaha Yaha Saha Phalitaha He Sake. Here, Drida Bhumihi is an adjective for that Yatnaha. So everything else, now Drida Bhumihi, Drida Bhumihi Yatnaha. So Drida Bhumihi, that extreme effort that I have taken. The Dridaha Yatnaha. Bhumihi means Adhara. Drida Adharena Yaha Yatnaha. That effort that has been made with a great. Let's say, I don't know how to even explain it in a normal way, because Dridabhumi itself means Dridabhumihi is Samskaraha. And Samskara Visheshat Yaha Yatnaha. So whatever Samskara we have, and because of that Samskara, we make an effort to do Nididhyasanam and Samadhi. That Samskara Yuktaha Yatnaha Phalitaha. Here, Drida Bhumihi means you are established in that process because of the force of that samskara which has pushed you into this. Ashubeshu samavishtam shubeshweva avatarayet. Vasana sarit, this vasana sarit is of two types, shubha, ashubha cha. So the samskara that we have in our mind is of two types. One is shubham and ashubham. Shubheshu, so ashubheshu samavishtam. If our mind is going, proceeding in that ashubha vasana, we have to forcibly try to put it inside the shubha vasana. Then only we can attain the drida bhumi, which is a very solid ground for samadhi, for nididhyasana. That is your drida bhumi. Drida bhumi is another technical term. Drida samskara, samskarasya karana, or samskara yuktaha yatnaha. Okay, you cannot get into samadhi unless you have a samskara, and that samskara only helps you into that samadhi, and that samadhi is done for priya praptau. And only when priya praptau sati, when that sakshatkara happens, mokshaha phalitaha. Now, tasya adhimatra upayasya tivra samvegata jushaha dridabhumihi. Now, all of these is, whose yatna is he talking about? Lokottaraha yatnaha kritaha, nididhyasana rupaha yatnaha atra kritaha, kasya yoginaha. So, tasya is, he is talking of some yogi, he sakhe. So he can't say my effort has become successful. Tamil, we have vindavar kandilai, kandavar vindilai. One who has experienced moksha does not talk about it. One who talks about moksha has definitely not experienced it. We are all only talking about moksha here, correct? So someone else is talking about another yogi who has attained moksha. So tasya yoginaha yatnaha phalitaha, priya praptau yatnaha phalitaha, mokshaha praptaha. So kaha saha yogi, yogi kathamasti, adhimatra upayasya. This adhimatram is drida jnanam. So adhimatra, actually it upayaha. Upaya is of three types in yoga shastram. You have mridu upaya, madhya upaya, and tivra upayam. Tivra upayam is also called as adhimatra upayaha. These three are the jnanam, that is no yama niyama asanam. The yama niyama asana and the ashtangas that you use for attaining that moksha or getting into that samadhi state, the stage before that drida bhumi is your upaya. And that upaya can be of three types. Mrudu upaya, where I can say, oh yes, I have control. I don't eat sweets, but I eat chocolates. So that is just one level of control of your senses, yama. Niyama, you don't follow all shastras. I do what I can. That is mrudu upaya. Madhya upaya is the next stage where you have a better control over your senses, a better shastra marga, pravrittihi, and all that. Then uttama is called adhimatram. That is your highest form of following the upayas, which is the ashtanga, yama, niyama, asana, etc. All of these can also be supplemented by mrudu samvegaha or madhya samvegaha, tivra samvegaha. The involvement with which you do all of these things also matters. That is your samvega. I don't know how correct I am. Just go with what I'm saying. That samvega can also, so the effort and the involvement with which you proceed in the path of your yatna, the path of samadhi or the nididhyasanam, is of 3 into 3, 9 types now. You can have mrudu upaya with a tivra samyoga or a mrudu samyoga or madhya samvega. In the same way, madhya upaya can be combined with mrudu samvega, madhya samvega, and tivra samvega. simultaneously for the Adimatra also. Now, to attain the yogi status and to attain a moksha, you have to have the combination of Adimatra Upaya and Tivra Samvega. Both of these should combine. That Tivra Samvega is also your Chitta Aikagriyam. That will only give rise to Chitta Aikagriyam. So, Tivra Samvega, that Samvega involvement, I am saying it as involvement, but when you go to the state of Tivratvam, you should not have involvement. That is your Samvega. So, Tivra Samvega actually means Tivra Parama Vairagyam Ityartha. A complete involvement or a Chitta Aikagriyam in the Atma Swarupa and a complete Viragatvam from the Vishaya, which is your Tivra Samvega. So, Tivra Samvegata Jushaha Tasya Yoginaha Eva Tasya Yatnaha Tadrisha Yoginaha Yatnaha Phalitaha Adya He Sake Pashyat. Okay, now this is the meaning of this shloka. Yeah, this is completely, there is no rasam in this, there is no beauty in the way he has brought out the concepts of it. Whereas if you look at Nivata Nishkampa, Nivata Nishkampa Miva Pradipam, the entire Advaita Vedanta Kalidasa would bring about. Every description, whether you take the Brahma description, Brahman description in the third sarga, sorry, I think the second sargam, and if you look at the Shiva's description or Vishnu's description, everything will be completely, he will use the Vedantic terms. In fact, in the Gunapaksha, he is going to talk about one shloka where Brahman is described as the akartavyam, when we look at that Gunapaksha, we will know. So here, it is so much of, you have to break each and every word and look at the Yoga Shastram so much to understand what he is trying to convey here. That the rasa itself is lost. Correct. So tasyadhi matra upayasya tivra samvegata jushaha dridabhumihi priya prapto yatnaha sa phalitaha sakhe atra adimatra upaya adayaha shabdaha. So you have to take it as adimatra upaya tivra samvega drida bhumi priya prapta prapti yatna ityadayaha shabdaha yoga shastra matra prayuktatvate apratitaha. So it's very difficult to understand the meaning of it because it is a shastreka vedyam. Only if you shastreva prasiddham and shastra, only if you know that shastra very well, you can understand it with that depth. If it is a person who knows that shastra and the vakta also knows the yoga shastram and the shrota also knows the yoga shastram, then it is very sulabham, it is a guna. We'll stop with this. Next class is Tuesday, is there? Okay.